Navdeep, Jamie, Navdeep is there, Navjot is there. Okay. Yeah. So, hi team. This is Vidya, your QA trainer.
Hi, Vidya.
Yeah. So, I'm sharing the screen. Are you able to view my screen? Please let me know. Yeah, I'm sharing the screen. Are you able to see my screen, team?
Yes, I'm able to see that.
Fine. Yeah, so let me introduce myself. My name is Vidya. Recently, my designation got changed as a test lead. I'm having 8+ years of experience.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Yes, dear, who is this?
That's Patel. So
yeah, hi,
maybe
Patel.
He's having some disturbance in voice.
Hi, Patel. This is Vidya, your QA trainer.
Oh, hi.
How are you?
I'm good.
Okay. So I'm sharing the screen. Are you able to see my screen?
Yeah, I can.
Okay, fine. So some just background noise, I got it. So if any doubts you're having, unmute and talk to me. Okay. Please make the mute by your end. If at all any doubts you're having, you can unmute and talk to me.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, fine. I'm having 8+ years of experience. This is my work experience, and also I'm handling the online classes. This is my information team. Please tell me about yourself one by one. So let's start with Navdeep. Please tell me about yourself.
Hi, I'm Navdeep Putra. I've worked as a UI developer for 1.5 years already, but I'm looking for a career change into the testing and or maybe something in the BA. I've done my master's degree from India. And right. I've done a diploma here, but that's not related to IT though. So that's all I have to say as of now.
Fine. So why you want to enter into the only QA? Why not any other technologies? Is there any specific reason?
I have been worked. That's what I was telling you, that I've already worked as a UI developer. And I feel that the pressure, the kind of pressure that developers face is not equivalent for the testers.
Yes, you're right.
Kind of day and night job for the developers. It's easy for me to wake up and test what's working, what's not working, rather than sitting there and writing the code itself.
Fine, Navdeep. Fine. Mm-hmm. So now, Patel, please. Yeah, thank you, Navdeep. No. So let's start with Patel. Patel, tell me, dear. Tell me about yourself.
Yeah, I did my associate degree in computer science.
Mm-hmm.
And now I want to do QA testing.
Fine. So, why only QA? Is there any specific reason?
Not really. So I can find jobs easily, I guess.
Okay. Is it to get the job in the QA? So that is a reason you're entering into the QA. That's fine. Yeah. Fine. Now just tell me about yourself. Thank you, Patel. Yeah. Now they tell me about yourself.
Hi, my name is Navjot. I have done master's in information technology from India. And I have also done the DBA course there. But I was here on H4, so I couldn't work here. And now I have got EAD course, so that's why I'm starting to work again. So that's the reason. Yeah.
Good. So thank you, Navjot. And Sarah is there, right? Hi, Sarah. Can you hear me? Yeah, anyone is left?
Yeah, ma'am, it's Samir here. So the coordinator between you and the students. So we'll just go ahead, ma'am. Maybe they are having some issue with their own mics and speakers. So they have not connected their mic and speakers properly. So they will get back to you once they're connected, okay?
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Samit. So, yes, team. So, let's start the session. What are all the things I'm going to explain you here is, first and foremost thing, I'm going to start with manual testing. Along with the manual testing, I'm going to provide you three real-time projects. Three real-time projects. In that, one of the project is banking project. So for this, you will get a documentation. You will get a documentation. Just observe my desktop here. I'm sharing one project to you. It is called banking project documentation. Around 43 pages of documentation for only one module. So just observe my desktop. This is my company's project I'm sharing to you. I'm working as well as I'm working as a trainer. I'm working in a i2c cab business solutions. So in that, I'm handling the three projects. So this is one of the project you can use in your resume. This is one of my real-time project. So nowhere you will get it, team. So this is given to me only, to you people. So along with this, one more project I'm providing to you. For that, you will get a software also. So basically, it is a patient details form, one of the medical related software. But I changed the title because my client is using, I changed it into the employee information system. You need to test this software. Complete real-time experience. You will get a hands-on experience in your, so you can use, this is one of the project in your resume. Wantedly, I made some mistakes in this project. You have to identify. As a tester, you have to identify the problems and you need to raise the defect report and you need to send back to development team. So one of the team is there, you need to send to them. So, and the project is called banking project. One is banking and the one is employee information system. For this, you will get a software plus documentation. Along with this, I'm going to provide you one more project. It is called student registration form. It contains two modules. Just observe my desktop. Like earlier, some government schools are there. They're using their student details in books. I'm talking about on 80s time. Some schools are using them, their student details in books. Now they want to computerize the works. So they're asking this software I'm releasing. Still my team is working on this project. So here, for example, what is a use miss? If you want to search any record, any student details, just click on, just enter the student name and click on search. You will get student details. This is one of the software you are going to use it. So total three projects I'm providing you. One is banking. For this, you will get a documentation. And the one is employee information system. For this, you will get a software also. And another one, student registration form. For this also, you will get a software. So you need to test these two softwares. So along with these projects, I'm going to provide some assignments in the class. You need to work on that assignments. Not only three projects, some assignments I'm releasing. Just observe my desktop. Some FRS documentations I'm sharing here. What is that FRS and all? In detail in a future session, we are going to discuss. So this is one of the documentation called flight reservation application, then employee verification form, some documentation and calculator. For this, you will get a software also. You have to test it. So next, contact us. So these are all the assignments you need to work in the class, and three projects you can use it in your resume. Now, after manual testing is completed, I'm going to start with automation testing. Automation testing. So automation testing tool called QTP, Quick Test Professional. Along with the automation testing tool, I'm going to provide you management testing tool. Management testing tool called QC, Quality Center.
Quick question here, Vidya. Will you be providing us with QTP software for our laptops?
Yes. QTP and Quality Center, that too, not a trial version, not a 15 days trial version. So our company is going to provide you one Oracle virtual machine is going to install in your system. In that, permanently these two softwares will be installed.
All right, perfect.
Until unless you delete it from your computer, nothing, it won't go. That much of security is given. Okay?
Sure.
Fine. So now after this, after QTP and QTC, just observe, complete my company's real-time experience I'm going to share you. So I'm going to start in such a way, just observe my desktop here. First and foremost thing, once you entered into the software company, what exactly information is given to you? From that level, I'm going to teach. Not just starting with the testing, definition of the testing. That you can get through online also. Just type what is testing, you will get plenty of the links. That is not the process team. See, first I'm going to start with how you're getting an emails. From that level, I'm going to teach you. So Office, Outlook, Web Access. So because most of the students, they don't have any real-time experience. I want to make you perfect in such a way, you can feel very comfortable in companies where you're working. When once you join in the companies. So that is the reason I'm going to start with this level. So Office, Outlook, Web Access. It is like once you entered into the company, all the tasks you will get through emails only. That email software is Outlook. So company to company, it will be vary. So here, this is my company's software called Office, Outlook, Web Access. All the tasks you will get through emails only. Exact your Gmail, how you are using your Gmail, in the same way Outlook is going to use it. So after that, see, one of the server where your complete projects is going to install, that server name is Visual Source Safe. This is one server database location where your complete projects are going to install. So as a tester, you should have some knowledge on this. You're not going to create any folder structure to maintain the projects and servers here. Just you need to access this server to get the project. Your project details will be stored in this server location. You need to get this location from, you need to enter into this location and you need to get the details. So this information also I'm providing, like communicator. So within the company's interaction purpose, so if you want to interact with your colleague, just communicator is going to use it. So example, I need to discuss with my team members. Just I'm going to message them like so-and-so time we are having a meeting. Official email will be there, but in minutes of meeting, just I'm going to message them. Like that is called office communicator. So next one, share folder. So within the organization only, if you want to send some files, some bunch of data, one department to another department, we are going to use work group. So here, this is to share some data from one system to another system. This process is going to use it. Then how you're getting an emails, how to reply the emails, from that level, I'm going to teach you. So these are all my company's real-time environment I'm sharing to you. If you're having any doubts here, you can ask me, team. Any doubts? Yes, Patel, Navdeep. Having any doubts?
No.
Fine. So let's see. So these are all my company's real-time experience or real-time environment. Real-time environment I'm going to provide you. So here, live class will get recorded. You will get a recording files also. You will get our concerned person is going to provide you the recording files to you. You can use that recording files. So next, here, let's see. Our classes will be in general Monday to Friday. Saturday, Sunday, no classes. Monday to Friday, our regular classes will be there. 1 hour session will be there. Every day, 1 hour session. And like weekends, there was no class. So before going to start the next class on Monday, example, 1 week classes are done. So next Monday, just you will get a interaction sessions, like just simply we are calling it as a slip test. I want to make you perfect in a subject in such a way you should feel that after my class is completed, you should feel that, yes, with your thoughts, something, I'm having something in my hand, that confident I need to build in you. For that, just general discussion will be there in every Monday's class. So I'm going to discuss with you the subject, where you are in the subject and all. Now, here, let's see. Resume preparation. With mock interview. So after that, at the end, resume preparation with mock interview, we are going to discuss. These are all the general things we are going to discuss in the class. If you're having any queries here, you can ask me, team. And the duration here, duration is 5 to 6 weeks time it will take to complete the course. Manual with the three projects, automation and quality center, management tool. Having any doubts, queries here?
So we won't be covering the SQL in this one?
No. SQL, just simple basic queries will be used in QTP. But specific, separately, we are not going to cover any SQL part here.
Okay, so we wouldn't be getting an access to SQL Navigator to practice or something like that, right?
Yeah.
So just the basic SQL that we can go through.
Yeah, basic SQL, basic statements, which we are going to use it in QTP. Just you need to enter into the database and check the whether the entered data is getting stored or not.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
that part we're going to learn in QTP.
Okay. And will there be like basic knowledge for VB scripting given or...
Yeah, not only basic knowledge, VB script is going to use it in automation tool. You okay, have to learn that one.
Under QTP.
Yes.
All right. Thank you.
QTP, it is going to cover.
All right, sure.
How to write, not only recording, how to write manually also, I'm going to teach you. Very easy method, I'm going to explain you here.
Perfect, Vidya. Thank you.
Fine. So, now let's start the basic topic here. Now, you are all entering into the software company. That too were in testing department. DEPT means department. That too, what is your role? Tester. What you are going to do? That part we are going to discuss in later. So before entering into the testing department as a tester, what you are doing, first and foremost thing, you should know what exactly works done in software company. Without knowing of this, how come you are entering into the testing department? First, a basic information you should know. So, what kind of works done in software company? This point you should know. So, let's see. Let's talk about this topic. So, if I am asking the same question to Navadeep, you tell me, dear, in general, what kind of works done in software company?
They develop the different applications.
Okay.
They and develop. They can modify the existing applications. And the applications could be some websites or some internal applications.
Fine. Fine. Simple point. They develop some applications. Okay. Now, Jyot, you tell me, dear, according to you, what exactly software companies are doing?
Maybe they are working on any kind of apps, application development, or testing them, or they are just porting like portability between two applications or anything like that.
Fine. So simply, you are also saying they are going to develop the applications. Good. Now, Patel, you tell me, dear, according to you, what exactly software companies are doing? Yes, Patel, are you there? Fine. So whatever you said, absolutely correct, team. So in detail, I'm going to explain you now. So I'm talking about throughout the world. Throughout the world, 80% of the software companies, 80% of the software companies are developing projects and products. So these projects and products, as you said, it's nothing but some companies are calling it as a softwares. Some companies are calling it as applications, as you said. Some companies, they're calling it as a build. Different companies are calling it as a different names, but the thing is, it's nothing but a project and product. Then what about rest of the 20% of the companies? What they're doing is they're dealing with outsourcing, like telecalling, telemarketing, customer care services. You least bother about this BPO sector works. BPO means business processing outsource. You least bother about this BPO's work. Your target is what? Your target is to enter into the software company who develops the projects and products. Right? And those projects and products, as a tester, you need to test it. So you are entering into the testing department to test the projects and products. To test projects and products. This is your target. Is this point is clear?
Yeah.
Good. How it is developed, how it is developing, we least bother about those things. How to test, you should know. Now, let's see. So before going to the testing, first you should know what is project. So this point we are going to discuss now. So again, without knowing the minimum knowledge on project, how come you are testing? You should know something about the project. So for that, let's discuss. So let's say, for example, A is one person. That person wants one pen for writing purpose. He's having his own needs. So what are all those needs means? That person wants one pen. He's having some needs, like A person is saying, I want one pen. That pen body color should be blue. And one tattoo should be there in the pen. And it should be right in blue color. It should be right in blue color. So this is the needs of that A person. Now, with this needs, what this person's doing here is, here this A person wants one pen and this pen needs are this. Now, with this needs, this person is coming into my location. Who I am means, I am developing, example only. My job is to develop the pens. That person is coming to my location and asking to implement one pen. So what I'm doing, I analyze these information and I'm saying to this A person, if you come after 2 days with the cost called around $50, I'm going to develop the pen for you. Just an example. This person agrees. Once the agreement done between A and me, immediately this person is belongs to client for me. And this needs, technically very important point, we are calling it as a requirements. So with this requirements only, what I did here is I developed pen like this. Just observe my desktop here. I developed a pen like this and I'm releasing this pen to that A person only. See, blue color pen, one tattoo means one picture is there and it is writing in blue. So this is called project. So what is project here is, project is something which is developed based on client requirements and used by that particular client only. Not to the X person, not to the Y person. A is the responsible person to use this pen and this pen is the project. Again, I'm repeating, what is project means? Project is something which is developed based on this A person requirements, means based on client requirements, and it is developed by client requirements and used by that particular client only, is called project. Is this point is clear, team?
Yeah.
Yeah, and one more important point, no need to write the running notes. I'm going to provide you complete notes to you. No need to write any running notes. I will provide the notes. Not only this class notes, along with this, a few more notes are there that I'm going to provide to you. Okay. So then let's see. According to you, anyone in the class, please tell me, what do you mean by product then? You understand project now. What is product?
Product is the final thing which the developing team is making.
Final thing means this is the pen?
No, this is what client needs, right?
Yes.
the product will be the thing which the software company is making for the client.
Software company is making for the client is product.
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Okay. So here most of the students, what they're saying is, so who is the client then? Here right now in the example, who is the client according to you?
Client is a person who needs the pen.
So the pen which I developed, is this the pen is product now?
Yeah.
So most of the students are making a confusion here only. So what they're doing is, what they're saying especially here is, when project is when the pen is developing in the company, it is a project. When it is released to client, it is a product. How come it is? Then if this is the answer, then why I should say companies are developing projects and products? Simply I can say project or a product. Na? Both I can't say if your answer is correct. So there is a difference, my dear. There is a difference between project and product. Let's see. See, what is my job here? Example, I used to develop the pens. This is my business. So what I'm doing here is I want to improve my business. So I'm searching in the market what kind of pens most of the users are using. I want to improve my business. I'm searching in the market. I got this list of pens. I'm analyzing best features of this pen. First, yellow color pen, maybe because of the color. So I captured one best feature. Red color pen, way of writing is very smooth. I captured that one. So blue color pen, cost is very low. So I captured some best features of this pen. As a pens developer, I created my own requirements. No one is giving the requirements to me. I created my own requirements. I developed pen like this and I'm selling this pen to multiple users in the market. This is called what? No. This is called product. So product is something which is developed based on company's own requirements and sell to multiple users in the market. Project is something which is developed based on specific client requirements. Based on this client requirements, we created and we are providing to this client only. Copyrights belongs to this A person, not to the X person, not to the Y person. Whereas come to product, anyone can use once they purchase it. So best example for project and product is, every day you are using Gmail account, your Google. So just now you logged into the meeting. So those are all nothing but what? Those are all nothing but a products. You can ask me, how come it is product? I'm not purchasing, means. Why you are not purchasing, my dear? You are paying internet connectivity bills. Means back end some indirect business is going on. We least bother about these things. And your Skype is one of the product. Yahoo Messenger is one of the product. And what is project, miss? If you go to any banking location, you have given your account number, concerned person will search your details by entering your ID in one software. The software which is used by that bank persons is nothing but a project. Within that bank organization, backend team, support team only use those softwares, or it's called project. Having any doubts in project and product team?
No.
Fine. So is it clear, all of you?
Yes.
Navdeep, Navjot?
Yeah, it's clear.
Fine.
Very good.
So, fine, dear. Now, you understand what exactly meaning of project, what exactly meaning of product also. This project and product, as a tester, you have to test it. So, let's see. Basic information regarding testing. What is testing? In detail, we are going to discuss. So these are all the basic things we are going to discuss here. Then actual class, once I got the confirmation, we are going to start. Let's see what is testing now. What is testing? In detail, we are going to discuss here. See, if I'm asking, in your day-to-day life, I'm not talking about any technical. In your day-to-day life, are you going to do any testing? Anyone in the class? Day-to-day life, regular activities I'm talking.
What kind of testing you're talking?
In general, in regular activities at your home, are you going to do any testing kind of work?
Yes, ma'am. We used to do.
Yeah. What it is? Give me one example.
For example, if we go to the market, if we went to buy some vegetables, we test there something that is a proper thing which we are going to buy or not.
Very good. So, is that vegetables are the fresh, is there freshness is there or not, you are checking. That checking is nothing but a one of the testing only. And simple example, when I'm preparing food, before providing to my family members, I'm going to taste it. I want to see whether that food, all the ingredients are mixed properly or not. That is also one of the testing. That tasting is nothing but a testing in generally, and that kind of testing only you're going to do in the work location also. So see, my dear team, programmer's job is not at all an easy job. Just now our friend said, because of hectic work is there, day and nights I need to work. That is a reason I want to shift my career from programming to testing. Why she said in that way? Because work itself is very tough. See, I'm not criticizing to any developer's job. Frankly speaking, one of the toughest job position in the software company is programmer's job. See, this type of code writing is not an easy job. Just observe here. .NET developer is there. He's using Microsoft Visual Studio, one of the software, where they're going to write some kind of code in this way. So writing this code is not at all an easy job for them. So obviously they made a mistakes in their coding side. Or else, see, just observe here. I'm browsing one browser called here in this. Just browse one Google page here. Here, for example, right click on this page and click on view page source. Back end, this type of code is written. So only this is for designing purpose. Again, in this functionality code is there. Do you think it is an easy job, team? Writing this type of code?
Nope.
No, not at all. One of the toughest job position in the software company's programmer shop. And obviously they made a mistakes in their coding side. That mistakes will get reflected in front end application. That mistakes only as a tester, we need to test it. That is our job. So let's see what is testing with one example in detail we are going to discuss. Let's say for example, here X is a person. That person wants one login application and they have given some requirements. So requirements means needs of a person. He's saying that I want one login application. In that, username should be there, password should be there. After entering username and password, when I click on OK button, it should navigate to next page. So this is the requirements which is given by X person. With this requirements only in the company, developer used to develop this type of code. So I told you, writing code is not an easy job. So definitely there is a mistakes. So once the application is developed by developer, they release it as a build one to the testing department. Now as a tester, what you're doing? Let's discuss now. So here, based on the requirements only, you have to test it. You're checking login title is there or not. Yes, it is there. Password is there. Username is there or not. Yes, it is there. Password is there or not. Yes, it is there, but there is a typo mistake. Okay, button is there or not, you're checking. It is there, but there is a mistake. This mistakes in technical, we are calling it as a defect. So first, what is defect means? It is deviation. Defect means deviation from client requirements. In software is called defect. Then what is testing here is, see, once you identify the defect, simply you're not calling, hey developer, please come to my system location, see there is a mistake like this. You're not calling to any developer here. Once you identify the defects, what you have to do is you need to prepare one report called defect report. See, in future session, you're going to learn your practical session called writing test cases, one part, writing test data, one part, and preparing defect profile, one part. These are all your practical sessions. One is review report, another one test cases, then test data preparation, defect profile. So you are preparing one defect profile. This defect profile only you are sending to developer to fix that problems or a mistakes. So let's see. What is testing here is, testing is the process in which defects are identified. Once you identify the defects, what you are doing here, you are going to prepare one defect report. That defect report you are sending to developer. Now what developer is going to do? Developer is going to rectify those mistakes. They are releasing one build, next build, to the testing department with the clarifications. Again, as a tester, what you are doing, you are rechecking. Is this problems got resolved or not? You are rechecking. If the problems got resolved here, what you are doing here, it is a quality project, you are going to release to client. If still there is a problems, means again you are preparing defect report, again you need to send to developer. So what is testing means, it is the process. It is the please make it mute by your end, team. It is the process in which, yeah, thank you. It is a process in which defects are identified. Then what you're doing, you're going to group together. And prepared defect profile. You have identified the defects and you group it together and prepare defect profile. That defect profile subjected for rectification to developer. So this is my company's terminology team. So what I'm doing in my company, that I'm presenting here. So subjected for rectification to developer means, simple word, sending to developer. Sending to developer. So to ensure that the project is defect free, in order to provide the, or you can say process software also, in order to provide the quality project to client. This is called testing. Very, very important definition. So it is one process in which defects are identified, grouped together, prepare one defect report. That defect report we are sending to developer. Now developer will rectify it. They release the next build to the testing department. Again, as a tester, you are rechecking. If there is no mistakes are there, then it will be the quality project we are releasing to client. This is called testing. Unmute and talk to me, team, if you're having any doubts here. Navdeep, now Jyot, is that clear?
Yes.
Yeah.
Fine. Now, let's see. Now you understand the meaning of testing and defect. Now, let's see. General meaning of quality. According to you, what is quality? Anyone in the class? What is quality according to you?
Features.
Quality means features? No.
Quality is how correctly the software is working, or the client is how.
Yes, if software is working perfectly, then it will be the quality, right? So simple point here. Navdeep is asking to implement one, develop one pen. Pen body color should be yellow. If I created blue, will Navdeep accept this pen? She is asking yellow. I created blue color. She won't accept. Though this pen is working fine, she won't accept because her requirements are not reaching. So it is a defect now. Then what is quality, miss? If Navdeep is asking to create one pen, the pen body color should be yellow. If I created this pen, now she will accept. She is asking to implement one pen, one tattoo and all should be there. I created. Now she will accept. Her requirements are reaching here. So she's going to accept now, right? So what is quality means? Justification of client requirements. Justification of client requirement in the project. In the software is called quality. That's fine. If you agreed this point, then one more option here. Here, Navdeep is asking to implement one pen. Pen color should be yellow. It should be write on yellow page only. That too with yellow ink. If I created this pen like this, her requirements are three. Pen body color should be yellow with one tattoo. Yes. And one, this pen should be write on yellow page with yellow ink. If I created this pen, will Navdeep accept? Anyone in the class, please give me the answer. Yes, team.
No.
Why?
Maybe the requirements was not correct because yellow pen cannot write on yellow paper.
Yeah, here client is the your view is correct, but requirements are given by client. Okay, so but software company should not create, and it is not a quality project because whatever you are writing here, it can't be viewed here, right?
Yeah.
So here, especially what you need to think here is client is not a technical person. Client can ask n number of things. Software company's job is to educate the client if it is not a clear or if it is a confused requirement. Here, client has given, my pen should be write on yellow page with yellow ink because client don't know about the software, how to use it. So he is not a technical person. He can ask n number of things. Company's job is to educate the client. Blindly, we should not create, yes, client is asked in this way, we can implement. No, this is not the process of implementation. So here, this is not the quality pen also. So what is quality means? Not only justification, it should add some values. It should be user friendly. See, we need to educate boss. Your requirements are wonderful, but it looks better if you change the ink color instead of yellow. Make it as a red or a black. Then only you can view it. Then only it will be useful to you. Like this, we need to educate the client. We, in the sense, marketing team is gonna reach there. There's locations and they're gonna educate the client. So here, what is quality means? Quality means justification of client requirements in the software, and it should add some values in the software. Adding some values means user friendly. User friendly. Then it is called quality. So what is quality means? Justification of client requirements in the software, and also it should add some values in the software is called quality. So as a tester, what is your job means? You need to test the software by identifying the defects to provide the quality project to client. That is your job. Tester job is what? Tester job is here testing the software, testing defect and quality. So here, what is your job is testing the software by identifying the defects to provide the quality project to client. This is your job, my dear team. And to be frank, it is a dead easy job in the company because developer mindset is what? How to make it. And tester mindset is what? How to break it. Our job is to break the software to provide the quality project. Ultimate job of the job in the software companies, that to developer job is to implement the software based on the client requirements, and tester job is to break the software to provide the quality project. We need to confirm whether the software is developed properly or not. So approach is different by developer and tester, but goal is same. They have to provide the quality project to client. This is called testing. And here, after the topic completed, immediately I'm going to provide some FAQs, frequently asked question also. See, you understand what is project here. The meaning of project means here, it is something which is developed based on client requirement and used by that client only. Then what is product means? It is something which is developed based on company's own requirement. Based on company's requirements, those requirements in technical, we are calling it as a specifications. And used by multiple users in the market. So frequently asked question here is your company project based or product based? This is one of the interview point of question. Your best answer should be your answer should be project. Don't say product. If you're using product, definitely they're going to ask you, show me some products which is sold out in the market. So you can use, best answer is, my company is project based. They never ask why your company is not product based and all. They never ask. Is this point is clear? And here for this, what is your job? And generally FAQ, frequently asked question is, what is testing defect and quality? You need to give the answer of these three definitions, because very basic question is, what is testing? Simply they used to ask, what is testing? You have to give this answer. Is this point is clear, team?
Yes.
Good. So I didn't started anything about exact subject. Just to overview what is testing in general, I have given. So next, general departments in software company. Software company. Let's see. Here, first one, development department is there. In that, one of the role is developer. Their job is to implement the code in this way. Back end, they're going to write this type of code. Just observe my desktop. This type of code, which is written by the developers. Programming language they're going to use. Example, it is a .NET code. Then, their job is to implement the code. Then, database admin department. Database admin department. Here, role is administrator. Their job is to taking care of database works like backend. Here, just observe here, if you are using any Gmail account, first you need to create an account. Creating an account means front end, whatever data you are entering, it is getting stored into the backend Google server database in the form of table structure. So this database is maintained by one of the department in our company is administrator department. As a tester, what is your job here, miss? You can test the data which is stored or not. That in QTP classes we will discuss. Entered data is stored in the database or not, you can test it. But you are not creating database, remember. This is not our job as a tester. So database admin department job is to create the database. Then our department called testing department. So role is tester. What we are doing, we are going to test the software which is developed by programmers. Then next one, marketing department. Role is business analyst. So what is a business analyst job is? Like they're going to get the projects into the company, market the products into market. So selling the products into the market and getting the projects into the company. So that is a job done by marketing department. Then next one is networking department. So role is deployment engineer. Deployment engineer. So what is the job of the deployment engineer means? They're going to take care of software related information, hardware installation, software installation process, they will take care. So that is a networking job. Next one is HR department. Role is HR associate. You know very well about HR jobs. They're going to take care of salaries of an employee. They can, they're going to check the insurance policies and all. So shortlisted resumes, the resumes will be there. They're going to make a call and they're going to fix the interview time and date. So those general things will be done by HR. So these are all the general departments are there in the company. Your department is testing. What you are doing in detail, once I got the confirmation, we are going to discussing. Like on tomorrow or a day after tomorrow, we are going to start the exact class. Here, just a basic information I have given. Okay, team. So with this today, I'm ending up the session for now. You just discuss with your company person and let me know so that we are going to move on to the next step. Is it clear, team?
Yeah, sure, Vidya. Vidya, I have another quick question. Will you be covering up the BA also, or are you just going to go through the QA?
Only QA, dear. QA plus automation. Okay. Not BA.
Sure, because I had a discussion with Samir and he said that we're going to cover BA and QA, so he might be giving us some different instructor for BA, right?
Exactly, exactly. Some other instruction is there for BA. He's going to take the class, okay?
Hi. Okay. Yeah, sure, thank you.
Fine. So anything else, team?
No, thank you.
Fine. So Samir, with this today, I'm ending up the session. So discuss with the students and let me know when we can start the class, okay?
Okay, ma'am, fine.
Okay, thank you, Samir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, team. Okay. Bye-bye, take care.
Thank you, Vidya.
Bye.